What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Ride the Gus Bus podcast. I'm your founder and host, Gus Kirkpatrick. New this year, we got two new co-hosts, Sharpshooter Steve, Big Play Shay. Unfortunately, Big Play Shay can't be here. He's got another interview. He's really working on getting a job. Unfortunately, me and Zeke are still unemployed. But instead, we got his replacement, new guy in town, 10 Leg Tom. He's crafty, he's nifty, he finds the right buttons and presses them and creates 10 leg parlays that rarely miss. So he'll be giving one this pod. We'll all be tailing with $20 because it's that much of a loss. And as always, we'll start off by reviewing last week's picks. Without further ado, let's get into the good stuff. Did Shay send you his picks from last week?
He sent it to my manager. I can read it, but she might go with yours.
Oh, he sent him to Siegel. Yeah, just read Shay's picks from last week just so we can get those out of the way.
So last week, Big Play, he had... The Seahawks plus 8.5, which cash. Chargers minus 5.5, which cash. We're all over that. Jets plus 2.5 is an L. Chiefs minus 6 an L. And we had the Bengals plus 8.5, which was a cash. He went 3-2. Me personally.
So you went 3-2.
3-2.
All right. Well, then let's start out. Let's review.
I also went 3-2. I had Seahawks plus 8.5, which was a win. Chargers minus 5.5. Win. I took the Eagles plus 2.5. I thought they were going to keep it way closer than they did. Great performance from the Niners. I had Chiefs minus 6.5. I think we were all over that one. It was a Gus Bus pick. And then a good play, in my opinion, on the nightcap. Monday, Bengals, Jags over 38.5. So I went 3-2. Shay went 3-2.
I was on the Seahawks plus 8.5. They win, or they don't win. They cover, though. The Cowboys win 41-35 in the best game on Thursday Night Football of the year. DK Metcalf scores 3 touchdowns. Dak plays well, but I think Pollard got one. CD got one. Cooks got one. Not sure who else got one. I think Deron Bland had another interception. And the Cowboys just pull off the comeback. They were down 35-30, I think. End up winning this one 41-35. They stay hot. With a big upcoming matchup against the Eagles on Sunday Night Football this week.
They're favorites.
They're favorites at home after the Eagles' big loss to the Niners. I had the Cardinals plus 5.5 in Pittsburgh after a long couple rain delays. I think that game lasted 5 or 6 hours. The Cardinals pull out the win outright, 24-10. Kenny Pickett goes down with an injury, so it's the Trubisky show now. And the Cardinals cover the 5.5 spread, so I'm 2-0. I'm obviously on the Niners, minus 2.5 over the Eagles. They can win there and just do a lot of bad things to the Eagles. Step on their faces, just kick them in the dirt. The Eagles didn't stand a chance. It was awesome to see them going to Philly with all those fans going crazy, all those fans talking shit. Debo talked all the mess and stood on business and scored 3 touchdowns. Brock Purdy looks great. He's now the favorite for MVP, which is a little bit crazy.
Brock Purdy?
He's a favorite for MVP, yeah. They win 42-19. And the Niners might have the most impressive wins on the season with 42-19 over the Eagles, 42-10 over the Cowboys, I think 37-3 over the Jags. So they're not just beating good teams, they're demolishing good teams. Sunday Night Football, like Siegel said, we're all on the Chiefs. They go to Green Bay and lose 19-27. Jordan Love looks good. I don't know what's up with Mahomes this year. He's not having a Mahomes-esque year. They're going to need to turn it around if they want to go for that one seed. I think the Dolphins or Ravens have it because the Jags lost and fell out of it. I think the Dolphins have it right now. Then Monday night, like I said, the Jags lost. They were minus 8.5 over the Bengals at home. The Bengals come into town and beat him. Lawrence goes down with an ankle injury late in the game, but Jake Browning was the story of the day. Joe Mixon rushed for 2 touchdowns, had a bunch of catches too, so he's playing great. But Browning really looks solid. I think he only had a couple incompletions in the first half. Played some good football. It didn't look like the offense was restricted for Browning. Burrow is out for the year, obviously, so it'll be the Browning show from here on out. We'll see. It could sneak into the playoffs, but... Even if they do, it's not like they're going to make it going against the powerhouses in the AFC. Jags fall out of first place in the AFC and lose. Hopefully Lawrence is back this week because they need him. They're playing a Browns team that has a great defense. We shall see. My anytime TD was DK. That cashed and then some as he scored 3. So cash that. Takes me from 33-21-4 to 36-23-4. Siegel is 36-25-24-3. Sorry, 36-24-3. Wait, how?
I want 3-2.
Oh, yeah. I'm stupid. Seagull's 36-24. Wait, what? 36-24-3. And Shea is 31-28-4. Me and Siegel sit atop the leaderboard with a slight edge to Siegel, I think, because he has one less loss. And Shea is back a couple games from us. As we all know, the winner gets dinner, treated to the better loser.
You are like a half.
Do I have the tiebreaker? I'm 36-23. Oh, you have one more loss.
Yeah, one more loss, one less tie.
Exactly. So I'm slightly edged. All right, take it to Thursday night. Let's actually ramble off Shea's picks real quick. Or you have them.
So Thursday night, he's got Steelers, Pats, under. Little precursor. I also am on the under. Both offenses suck. Both defenses are pretty good. I think they're actually both really good. Thursday night's going to be cold. I don't think much passing the ball. So under 30.5. And then he has Bengals +1.5, Broncos +2.5, Eagles +3.5, Packers -6.5, and Dolphins -13.5. Two Monday night games this week. Same time.
They're not great games, not unfortunately. Great games. I don't know why they did that. Why are there two Monday
nights? But I gave my Thursday night pick. I have Pat Steelers under 30.5.
Wait, real quick, before you go on. I forgot to mention you and Shea both missed your anytime TDs last week.
I had Chargers defense.
He had Jets defense. No good.
So, little stat for it. The Steelers haven't scored more than
10 points. So you got the under 30.5?
Yep. That's the Steelers haven't scored more than 10 points in a game since since week 10. And the Pats in the past three games have scored a total of 13 points. So both these offenses are atrocious. Both these defenses are lights out. So I mean, I don't see the Pats scoring more than a touchdown, if that. I don't see the Steelers scoring more than two, if that.
Another key is pick is out. It's Trubisky.
It's Zappe.
And Ramondre is also out.
Ramondre and the entire
Najee is playing.
The entire receiving core for the Patriots is out, except for Juju, who is on the worst contract in the league. Yeah, it's going to be a barn burner in a bad way.
I haven't really been touching over-unders. I had Pats +6, and I just got a gut feeling that Trubisky is going to come out and ball for some reason. I don't really know why. But I literally just switched it. I'm now on the Steelers. I think their rushing attack with Najee and Jalen is good, and they have way better wideouts than the Pats do. Deontay Johnson, George Pickens. And then Allen Robinson, and they also have Muth. Pat Freiermuth.
That is actually also leg number one.
No way.
Leg number one is going to be -6, Steelers.
Love
obviously
it.
Our Pats.
I'm glad
we'll see this guy. Saying our year. We're not putting any points on the board. What is it? Zero touchdowns and like.
We had zero last week, six the week before.
Siegel's stat. You've let up 10 points.
We've let up 10 points or fewer in three straight games, and we were 0-3 in that stretch, which is the first time since 1938.
Uh-huh. And
statistically, we ain't getting points.
Statistically, the worst defense in the history of the NFL.
And in the past four games, they've allowed the first least amount of points.
42 points in the last 3 weeks.
The Niners have
also been versus shit teams.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say,
too.
It hasn't
the Chargers haven't been
playing like these top teams.
I mean, the Chargers are a pretty electric offense.
And then it's Colts at and times. Someone.
Colts and Giants, yeah. But going to your Steelers, good run game. The Patriots have the third best rush defense in the league.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know. I just feel like Trubisky is going to be able to air it out a little more. He's going to play a little, I don't know. I just have a weird feeling. I like Mitch.
Yeah.
You know, the classic Mitch Trubisky tweet.
Yeah.
Fill me in here.
It's fucking...
Wait, he's like, I love...
Titties or something.
I love licking titties.
Yeah,
or something like that. Or something like that. So I think Mitch Trubisky...
Exactly. He's gonna lick our tits.
Yeah, I think Trubisky's going to come into this game. And he's going to play well and just play loose and free, which is what you want out of a quarterback. You just don't want him to be all nervous on edge.
At Pittsburgh, too.
At Pittsburgh, yeah, exactly. The terrible towels... I'll take us off. Sunday, first game. I am agree with Big Play Shea here. I like the Bengals. I loved what I saw last week out of Jake Browning. And I think they beat the Colts. The Colts are playing well as also. Gardner Minshew, it's two backups in here, rather, I guess. But Jonathan Taylor, I think, is out.
I don't know.
I think Jonathan Taylor's out. He was out last week. But the Bengals look great. If they can go into Duval and beat the Jags, then they can easily take care of business at home field and knock off the Colts and move to two wins in a row with Jake Browning. I love how the offense is flowing. Bengals plus 1.5.
I'm not on that game. Jake Browning did look really
What do you
good
think about that game, if anything?
Nothing.
Nothing. Okay.
Nothing for 10 legs.
I'm going to move
on. I'll give a recap on the whole leg count.
Of course.
Just to let you know, we're at 64,000 plus.
64,100 or 64,000?
64,000.
I'm going to move over to my first game, which I just got a sneak peek. You are also on this. I got Lions minus 3.5 against the Bears. I don't know why this like kind of feels like a trap.
That's
line,
what I was gonna say too. But it's just but keep it's, it simple.
It, yeah, it kind of feels free at the same time. And the Lions are electric. They covered this spread in the last time they played. They were down the whole game. However,
that was in Chicago. That was in Detroit.
Yeah,
and they had needed a comeback win.
I hope it's freezing cold in Chicago because Dan Campbell's gonna fucking love it. I think this is where the Lions really need to start playing well in the final push of the season. They're sitting at the 2 seed right now, I believe. If they keep winning and the Eagles lose another...
No, they're not. They're at the 3 seed.
I think they're at the 2.
The Eagles and Niners are ahead of them.
Well, they're still in it. They got a stronghold on their division. I did see, however, that the Packers are kind of creeping up.
And the Vikings are kind of right there, too. 3 games back or something.
But, yeah, so my first game is Lions minus 3.
I'm also on the Lions minus 3. Big Bears guy, I don't know. I might be some false confidence, but I like Justin Fields and I like DJ Moore. It also may just be that I have DJ Moore on my fantasy team, so I'm optimistic. But right here, I just don't think they have the cojones or the guts to stay with the Lions. Lions are a dominant team. I think right on the cusp of being Super Bowl contenders. So I'm taking the Lions here, keeping it straightforward. Lions minus 3. They go into Chicago and smash mouth football, run it down your mouth with Rhythm and Bruise, David Montgomery, and Jahmyr Gibbs. Take the Lions here, minus 3 over the Bears. Oh. Then
the action here from Ten Leg is a gritty local rivalry. We're going to keep it under.
I like it. What's under the number?
Under 43.5 is another leg of that lay. We'll go ahead and get on that right.
Love that. The Bears could only manufacture 12 points against the Vikings, so...
Well, so last time these two teams
it
played,
was over. It was like 60 bombs. Yeah. But I
like that pick. Should I give my second Sunday? I'm going to give my second Sunday pick here.
Oh, yeah, second.
I got the Texans and the Jets. Texans minus 4.5.
Mm. Also feels, Shay's not going to like that.
It also feels like a little bit of a trap line, but I don't understand.
In Houston? Texans,
I believe so, no. Yeah. No? Oh, yeah, no. It's in New York. I don't think that really plays. Oh, it's down to 3.5 now. Can I change that?
Mm-hmm.
I just don't really get how that's the line when the Jets are shoveling out Tim Boyle at QB. They asked what's his name, Zach Wilson, to start, and he said no.
I think that might have been hullabaloo. I don't know if that was real.
But regardless, if that's coming out of the locker room, it's bad. It's bad business. The Jets defense has kind of fallen off a little bit in recent weeks.
What was the score last week against the Falcons?
The Texans have only been looking better. No Tank Dell is a little bit of a hit, but 3.5 isn't a whole lot of points to cover against a bad team.
Oh, the Falcons at 13. Obviously, the Texans have a better offense. Yeah, if the Texans put up 20, the game's over. Like, not the game, the spread's over. Like, the Jets aren't putting up more than 2 touchdowns.
That as well is a leg in the lay is the over on this game over 33.5.
Wow, the over.
Over, because when you're considering, I mean, that's straight disrespect to the Texans by the odds makers here. You got to think, I mean, you're looking at the Pats-Steelers game with 30, they're going to go over 33.5.
Yeah, I think the mindset here is that the Jets,
it's gonna
are,
be a
putting up, Jets are putting up 7, Texans are putting up 20 or something.
Yeah.
It's that'll be an interesting one. Sunday night, are we good for Sunday night?
I'm ready to rock and roll.
Sunday night, Eagles, big, big, big tilt. Eagles at Cowboys. If the Cowboys win, I'm rooting for the Cowboys. If the Cowboys win, the Niners have the 1 seed in the NFC, which is crucial, as we all know. But I do have the Eagles here, plus 3. They've been had the hardest schedule in football the last couple weeks. Bills, Chiefs, Seahawks, or the Seahawks, I think, are coming up maybe. Niners and then Cowboys. And I think it's they're gonna get a win here. I think they're gonna win, not only cover but also win. They're too good of a team. They're being disrespected. What the Niners did to them is a testament to the Niners. I don't think it's a testament to how bad the Eagles are. They beat the Chiefs. They beat the Bills. It did take comeback efforts, but I think this one they really get in the lab. Sirianni cooks up some plays for Hurts. Hurts was banged up at the end. He was taking too long in the pocket. Their offensive line held up great. It was just he was taking too long in the pocket. Cowboys defense is great, but Deron Bland kind of showed some signs of Trayvon Diggs last week. He was gambling too much. I think he gave up 150 yards and 2 touchdowns to DK in the first half. It looked like he was playing for the picks rather than just playing good defense. I think the Eagles go into Dallas, hold on to the one seed, and win this one outright. If not, at least cover the 3-point spread.
I agree. I think it's kind of a get-right game for the Eagles. You're going to like this, Gus. The spread is actually 3.5 now. So
that's awesome.
That sucker yep. up. I think it's a get-right game for the Eagles. I think that the Cowboys have been playing really good football, but they haven't been playing really good competition. The Seahawks are a great team, no doubt, but like Gus just said, their defense got burnt by a good Seahawks offense, but I think the Eagles' offense is better. I think the defense gets burnt again, and I think the Eagles' defense stands on their head a little bit here in Dallas, divisional game. Keep it close, 3.5. Can't give this team points.
We gave them points last week, and how
those are two jugs going out, though.
Before we move on to Monday night, I want to hear a couple opinions on the MVP race. Because just think about this, they have Dak up there.
I think
they have Brock up there.
Dak statistically, Lamar,
Jalen are up there.
Dak statistically is having a crazy season. I don't hate
him. Who do you give the nod to right now?
Right now, if the season were to end, it's tough to say because the Eagles have. As a Niners fan, I know you're going to disagree, but the Eagles, up until this point, I mean, really last week, they were the best team in the league.
I think it was Jalen
last week. I don't think you can give it to Jalen, though, considering the number of turnovers he has. I also don't think you can give it to Brock Purdy, because I think if you remove him and put someone else in there, the Niners are almost just as good.
Agreed.
So I think if the season were to end right now,
It has to go to Christian McCaffrey. You know what I was going to say? And I think it's easily better Christian McCaffrey is Tyreek Hill.
I disagree, though.
He's on track to be the first ever 2,000-yard receiver in a season. Granted, he will have an extra game over Calvin Johnson. But how can you not give it to Purdy?
Because I think he's not the most valuable player on that offense. I think if that offense without Purdy is way better than that offense without McCaffrey. Just looking at some stats, McCaffrey has 17 total touchdowns in the year and 1,500 total yards. I mean, like, that's just, like, game-changing.
There's no doubting that he's a beast.
Yeah.
That's game-changing. I think he's the most valuable player on that stacked. Team. Yeah.
And also, I think, again, the odds makers are disrespecting, I agree with Hill, disrespect.
Yeah.
Was it AP, last receiver?
He's a running back. Calvin last Johnson. Wait, what do you mean? Last year, but last what?
Last non-quarterback.
Oh, to win MVP.
To win MVP. But also, speaking of comeback player of the year, they put like DeMar Hamlin at like minus whatever. It's like, why is he in there? He's
played a couple snaps.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, obviously, like, what are they handing out? I mean, nothing against him, but you can't be handing out participation trophies.
I think I saw someone say they should make a separate trophy for him because it is a miraculous story. Like, let's go.
Great story.
Let's not be ignorant. Like, it is awesome that he even is willing to get back on the field. If that happened to me, I definitely wouldn't. I wouldn't put on pads in the first place. But if that happened to me, I wouldn't put the pads back on.
Absolutely, and I would not.
But so good for him.
At the same time,
but agreed, it's taken away from some other players that deserve the comeback more.
But at the same time,
such as who? Who do you think deserves comeback?
Well, I have no idea.
But let's think real quick. Like, last year, Gino won it, right?
Yeah.
And he had a great year coming off back from injury.
It's players that come back from injury. I think, let's look. NFL comeback.
But that's what I'm saying, though, is, like, the odds, nobody has any idea.
Yeah.
Nobody has any idea.
People just think it's locked in to be DeMar strictly because.
Tua. Oh, that's a really good one. Tua. Because remember, he got so many concussions last year. Yeah. Russ, because they were trash last year, now they're balling. Was Lamar hurt last year?
He got hurt at the end, right?
Imagine Rodgers comes back,
yeah,
throws up like 20 touchdowns.
How is Jake counting on it? That doesn't even make any sense.
Yeah, I guess the list isn't too great, but I think Tua should do it. Because
he's playing great.
I don't
think
he's in the MVP conversation.
I mean, he's
putting up crazy.
He used
numbers.
To be in it. He was in the MVP conversation.
24 touchdowns this year.
Like, if you're going to make the Purdy argument, you can make it about him, too. He's only him because he has Tyreek and Jalen.
Well, it's apples and oranges comparing the Comeback Player of the Year awards to the MVP.
No, I know. But what I'm just saying.
I don't think Tua is in the MVP race. But I'm just saying he's putting up great numbers.
Tyreek should be a lock for Offensive Player of the Year. What he's doing is absolutely
I think it should be
unheard.
Either Tyreek or McCaffrey.
Well, that's, yeah.
I don't think
obviously.
I don't think a quarterback should be in the race. Which is
no, this is for OPO. OPO dub. OPOY.
Yeah.
Regardless, we got off track a little bit. I digress. Purdy is in the lead right now. However, I don't think he'll win it. Monday Night Football. Titans go to Miami. Huge spread. The Dolphins are -13.5. I think they cover it. Mm-hmm. Will Levis at the helm for Tennessee. Derrick Henry was banged up. It looked like they said he was in concussion protocol, but then they took him out of it. A little confusing. I think the Dolphins win this game easily. The Titans aren't really a pass-happy team that can make comeback efforts. If they're going to win, they need to control the line of scrimmage and control the ball. Like, long possessions, run it down your mouth and drain the clock. I think the Dolphins jump out to an early lead here and then only improve on it. Levis throws a pick or two. Tua goes for two or three touchdowns. Dolphins blow them out in this one and cover the 13.5. You got that in the leg?
That is a leg.
What is it?
-13.5.
Are we riding the GB bus here?
I'm actually not touching the spread. Like anything double digits is like really weary. I do like the Dolphins, but like it leaves the door wide open for a backdoor cover here. So I'm actually touching the over, which I believe is 43.5 or something.
Big spreads usually lead to over, so I like
46.5. I think the Dolphins could easily cover that themselves if they don't.
Well, that's ridiculous.
I mean, they put up 45 last week.
True.
Both defenses are kind of candy. The Dolphins lost a massive piece in their defense, especially on the defensive line where the Titans will kill you in the run game. They lost
Jalen Phillips.
Jalen Phillips, yeah. So I think it's a big hit. I think Levis has the capability of airing it out. He'll be good maybe for a couple touchdowns.
Did they win last week? No, the Colts won an OT.
31-28, the Colts won, yeah.
That was a good game. He threw one to D-Hop late game.
So I like the over here. Not much to talk about, not much to think about. I don't think it's going to be a good game. I think there'll be a lot of points, though.
Mm-hmm.
You wait in your leg, Tommy.
I'm pretty sure teams with a spread favorited of like 12.5 and more this year are like 12-1 or something along those lines. So keep that in mind. You got the Dolphins as well.
I did.
What was your logic?
My logic behind that was that it's just going to be an absolute. I mean, unless Derrick Henry's putting up 6 touchdowns, then it's going to be a blow.
A molly-whopping.
I think the only way that the Titans keep this close is if Henry's healthy and they just run the ball the entire game and keep the ball out of Tua's hands.
Yeah, exactly. That's how Titans win ball games. But I think you can stack the box, send 8 to D. Henry, and Levis won't be able to make tight throws. One more game. We did 6 this week. Sorry if it's a little long. Packers go to New York and Tommy DeVito.
Tommy
Cutlets. Packers, I got a -6.5.
I'm
what
all
do you
over
think?
That, too. Packers are playing inspired football right now.
After beating the Chiefs last week, they're starting to come to life, starting to see some playoff hope through the light in the tunnel. The Giants are a good story. Everybody loves a Cinderella like DeVito, but I just don't think they can hang with the Packers here. What they were on bye last week,
and don't forget about Love. I think they think they have their guy now.
Yeah, Jordan Love's cool. I think they have their guy now. He's made some special plays.
Although,
I think Aaron Jones is still.
I saw a couple of TikTok montages of like people calling him out, saying that he's a joke. He's coming back now.
Yeah.
People got faith in him. He's feeling good. Green Bay's feeling good about him.
I would say he's very like hit or miss. I think Jordan Love. Yeah, Aaron Jones is questionable.
Mm-hmm.
Darren Waller's out though, so that's a good target.
Who did the Giants play 2 weeks ago? Was it the Pats? Because they were on bye last week.
Yeah, they beat the Pats.
No, oh yeah, I'm like missed kick field goal
in Pats fashion.
In typical tank fashion.
I will say, Belichick is the GOAT.
Even the GOAT at tanking. Even the GOAT at
tanking. Yeah, right. Packers here over the Giants. The Giants just don't. They have no offensive firepower. Saquon can't do anything when he has nine people looking at him every play. They don't trust DeVito to make any real passes. Take the Packers -6.5 here. Takes us into
wait. Tom.
Do you want me to give the lay?
Yeah, give the lay.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Tommy, 10 legs coming in hot.
Let me juice my app up real quick.
Yep, juice it up. For all you viewers, if you're looking for value,
this missed by one.
I provide value.
This missed by one leg last week and hit 2 weeks ago.
One leg. We're up $6,000 on the semester. So, starting at the top, Pat Steelers. We already discussed some of these, but Pat's Steelers. Obviously, I'm taking Steelers -6. So that's the first leg. Moving down, Panthers +5.5.
Ooh,
kind of a wild game. It's kind of just two dust teams going at it.
Derek Carr is questionable.
So we're taking the Panthers +5.5 there for leg number two. Moving in to Browns Jags, we're taking Browns -3. T-Law hurt.
He's questionable. He has a chance to come back, actually.
Does he?
So if he plays, we're voiding this because this is under the assumption that T-Law.
Either way, I think I'm going to ride it. This lay is going in. So that's, what is that, leg number three? Moving on, Buccaneers-Falcons. This is just a typical shootout. Over 40.5. Obviously, Lions-Bears, we already went that under that. So under 43.5 for that. On to the Texans-Jets, we went over 33.5. And then Seahawks-Niners, under.
Good. I thought you were going to pull some bullshit.
No. And by the way, 10 leggers, we don't take money lines. We take spreads.
No.
Yep.
No.
And over-unders. So we're going under 46.5 for the Niners-Seahawks game. Moving on, Broncos +2.5.
I love that.
Taking that.
Well, who are they playing on television?
Chargers, of course.
Obviously.
Who
else would they be playing?
Chargers, I mean, they should have honestly performed better against the Pats last week.
Yeah, let's be honest. Up with the Chargers.
So, I mean, Broncos +2.5. It seems like the only option here.
Quentin Johnson couldn't catch a ball.
We're gonna go ahead and skip the Chiefs Bills game.
I'm faster than Austin Eckler.
We're skipping the Chiefs Bills game. Moving on, Eagles +3.5. As GB was mentioning. And then as well as the Dolphins -13.5. So the 10 legs.
How much does 10 win?
10 wins. $6,430. Personally, that is great value. You have money all day going on, starting with Thursday night. We're gonna lock that bet in. If you want to go lower, you can go 5 to win $3,215. It's one of those bets where you just throw it out, and it probably will hit, considering my past choices.
Yeah, and I'm looking at the legs, and I truly don't get how it misses.
I know. It's one of those where you don't understand how they make this available.
Yeah. Like, what are they doing giving us these lines?
And accept it. Place
lock it.
Lock
it in.
Parlay plays.
Bingo.
Let's get rich.
You're going to want to bet this.
Value plays. Make money.
Before we get into wavelength, Tommy, remind me. The Chiefs-Bills game this week. None of us touched that. That one's going to be awesome. What was the spread on that? Chiefs -2.5 or something?
The spread
minus
on that was
-1.5.
Tight game.
That's going to be a great game. I don't really know who to pick. It's kind of a toss-up. KC looks terrible this year. Not terrible. KC doesn't look like themselves this year, but it's Mahomes, so you can't discount them. That's going to be awesome. Excited for that one. Time for wavelength. Do you know how to play wavelength?
I have no idea.
Wavelength is where I close my eyes, you guys come up with a number 1 to 10, and I get 3 questions asking you guys. So I'll say, like, say you pick the number 10. I ask the question, give me a food based on this number. You give me wings or pizza, something that equates on the scale of foods 1 to 10 equates to 10. At the end, I have to guess what the number is. Do you follow? Okay. We can do a practice game to get you up to speed.
I believe I follow. Let me just ask real quick. So I say,
Your eyes are closed. We pick a number, and then
so you pick 7. And then
seven.
I go, oh. And then you go category?
You'll go any question
you'll
in
go
the world.
Seegs, what is the best place?
Where do you rank Taylor Swift?
Yeah.
No. That's not. It'd be like places to get food around here. Yep. And seven, I'd be like, all right, what does Tommy like? We'll be like, he likes it, doesn't love it. We'll go Panera Bread.
Okay.
So I'm trying to get in your mind as the answer.
Gotcha. Okay.
You asked the question.
Yeah, we started off the first couple weeks going only football, and we ventured.
I like that.
We
like
ventured
that.
Out.
I like that.
C start. All right. So Tommy gets the hang of it. You can pick the number. You have honors. Just flash it to the camera. All right, boys.
All right, Tommy.
Yes.
Ask me first, just so he gets ready. He gets ready.
Gus. Give me...
He gets three questions, and then he has to guess.
Give me... This is a new one. I don't know how it'll play out. Give me a range of the region of the country to grow up in if you love football.
How about just a state?
Or state.
And I'm going to go... For our lifetime... Oh, you're not talking about an NFL team. You're talking about, like, a state that loves their football.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, interesting. Okay. I'm going to go Massachusetts.
Wow. Okay. Tommy.
Yes.
Give me a meal for lunch that Gary makes. Quote it with a number.
Keep in mind, lunch.
Lunch. Right. For a lunch meal, we're going to go with, this is a tough one. This is a very, very tough one.
Dinner was going to be easy. Dinner would have been too easy.
I think we're going to have to go, like, the chili bread bowls.
I didn't eat that yesterday. But they're good things.
But with the mozzarella sticks, let's not forget.
Yep,
the mozzarella sticks were part of the meal.
No doubt. Are we doing three or four questions?
Three. Should we do four? Let's do three. It's been long enough anyway.
All right. So this is for either of you guys to answer.
Third question goes to both people.
Mm-hmm. Give me a jersey number for a defensive back. Like 10 would be like a sick jersey number.
Mm-hmm.
1 would be like a dusty jersey number.
I think 1 would... Oh, yeah.
For a DB.
I think... Wait.
Like 22.
Okay. Now...
You were dealt a tough hand, see.
The first question... was related to which state loves football, and Gus said Massachusetts, which I viewed as like a 7-ish. The second question was a Gary meal, which I heard good reviews about, which I would also put in like a 7-ish range. But 22 for a defensive back is disgusting, in my opinion. Not disgusting, but now that you can wear any number, I'm just going to go 6.
Okay.
Your state question. He told me what to answer.
Where do you want to grow up and play football? You want to play in Massachusetts? Well,
he clarified, and he was like, "Oh, like where do people love football? Massachusetts people love football."
But dude, you gotta talk about Texas, Georgia,
California,
that's,
Florida.
Dude, that's 8, 9, 10. That's 8, 9, 10.
I think Massachusetts is probably on a lower scale of playing.
I thought you were talking about
like high school football.
I was thinking sub 5, like Maine, Vermont, like I don't know.
I think Matt's thinking about it. Love it in the middle of the country.
Like I kind of put it more towards like how many NFL players
also,
is that state producing?
A chili bowl like at 7?
Yeah, what are you talking about?
I didn't eat it, but I only heard good things.
I thought chili bowls a 1er.
I think it was flawed because I didn't eat it yesterday, but everyone that I talked to that ate it.
Why didn't you eat it? Because I was thinking about your head.
And what was the final question? DB number 22 is important.
That brought me down. Yeah, that brought me down.
Right, brutal first round.
That brought me down.
I'll take
That's
over.
That's the most off I've been all semester.
Let's do it.
See if you got the number.
Let me know when you're ready.
All right, we're ready.
It's Sunday night. You just...
What? Who is this to?
Tommy. It's Sunday night.
pretend you're living in. We ate Gary's food at 5. Now it's 11:30. We've just finished Sunday Night Football, and we're hungry again. What do you order for food?
You're ordering wings over.
That's not bad. Siegel, 2 minutes on the clock. You're down 4. So you need a touchdown. You don't need a field goal. Who do you want at quarterback? Leading draft.
This season or like?
This season. Okay. This season. Who's leading your 2 minute drill and you need a touchdown?
I'm going to go with I'm actually going to go with, this is tough. I'm going to go with Danger Russ.
Interesting.
And Mr. Unlimited.
Broncos country.
Let's ride.
Let's ride.
We are riding.
Final question. Final question. Give me one of the 7 Harry Potter movies or books. Have you seen them, Tommy?
I've seen them, but not thoroughly enough.
Should I do a new question, or do you want to take
it? No, see what we take. See what we take. I'm going to have to go with... I'm going to go with 3.
Which was not the...
It was the one... I'm pretty sure...
Was it Prisoners of Azkaban?
Azkaban was 2, I think.
Chamber of Secrets was 1. What was 3?
It was the one where Voldemort comes back to life, I think. Or was that 4?
4 was the Goblet of Fire.
That's the one where he comes back to life.
No, 3 is the
new one. New question. All right, I can't remember.
We're not Harry Potter savants.
No.
Final question. Give me a... Keep it classy. Give me a cereal.
You're a big cereal guy, though. I think for a cereal, we're gonna go with something like Frosted Flakes.
Oh, wow. I love Frosted Flakes. Oh, Tom. I love Frosted Flakes.
All right, let's recap.
Dangerous Wilson leading a 2 minute drill, Frosted Flakes for cereal, and a late night wings over. Frosted Flakes for me is an 8, 9, or 10. I love Frosted Flakes. Danger Russ is probably sitting at 6, 7, 8. And Wings Over is also sitting at 6, 7, 8. I'm thinking 6 or 7. I'm going to go 7.
Yep. Bang!
Well done, fellas. And that's how you do wavelength.
Wow.
Tommy, let's see if you can get any beginner's luck.
Numbers all do.
Number is... We got it, Bone.
All right, we're... Okay. Let me think. So, Super Bowl, right?
Yep.
Who do we have, not as a pairing, but, like, who is your main guy announcing this game?
So, an announcer.
Who's this to?
What?
Who are you asking?
Gus.
And this is an announcer, you're saying? Who's broadcasting?
Who do we want... being the voice of the Super Bowl. Niners are in it, too.
Okay. The play-by-play, not the color commentator, right?
No, play-by-play.
Wait, what's that? What do you mean?
Well,
like...
Play-by-play is radio. Color commentator is who you see.
Just, no. Who do we want on the broadcast?
Okay.
Not the pair, though. The main guy.
Main guy.
Like, Aikman's not a main guy. Romo's not a main guy.
Who's a main guy?
No, I consider both of them. I would consider Romo definitely a main guy.
I would say, like, Nance is a main guy... Joe Buck's a main guy.
I'm just saying.
I'm going to go...
Who do you want on the broadcast?
I'm going to go... Chris Collinsworth.
Okay. Collinsworth. Okay. Now, let's put it. You're looking to crash on somebody in the Pickle group chat's bed. Whose bed are you crashing on?
What time of the day is this? You got to give a little more.
This is.
Are you hungover after a darty?
You're looking to get a good nap in.
Well, here's my
and not be disgusted.
Here's a big clarifying question: is it the physical bed themselves, or is it the owner of the bed?
It has to do with the owner of the bed.
All right, I'm gonna say Lucas Meade.
Ooh. Okay. Really? Because I like Chris Collinsworth. I don't know if I'd be sleeping on Meade's bed. Okay. Now. Oh, okay. So this is tough. All right. Well, intramural flag football. Who do you want as your starting quarterback?
Wait, before we answer, let's think about this. No.
It's easy.
No. I think.
Do they have to have been on the team?
No.
Okay.
They can be, yeah, no.
Jake Handanian. No mobility, no.
Whoa, chill. Okay. So, I mean, bringing those three together, Lucas Meade's bed sounds to me like a 1, 2, or 3. Handy at quarterback sounds like a 0 or a 1. I mean, and Collinsworth, personally, I like Collinsworth. I think he's hilarious. I mean, I like Romo more. There's definitely a few guys I like more. But I guess Gus doesn't like him. And, I mean, obviously he says some stupid things every now and then. We're going to have to put it at 2.
Wow!
Yeah!
Well done, Tommy. Well done. I think the announcer one's hard.
You can't stop. It's two announcers. Yeah. And with Collinsworth, this season specifically, he's been getting a lot of heat.
Yeah, yeah. Everybody's been giving him shit.
I have.
It's hard to think of an announcer that's like a 2. No one's really awful. Because if you're an announcer, you know your stuff.
Right.
So we had to poop it down.
Right.
So I was seeing more of guys like I personally love Romo.
He wanted to say O'Toole for quarterback. That's not a 2 because no, he can actually sling it.
No, I know you hate O'Toole.
I would have put him in the lower range.
But I think a Handy's lower than an O'Toole.
Yeah.
Good to know. That's a wrap for today. As always, can't wait to kick back on the couch in Dunk's room for 7 hours of commercial-free football. Unfortunately, this is our last regular season football Sunday in Syracuse at the house. We are going home for winter break, and we'll be watching the rest of the regular season
With the pod next week.
We'll be doing the pod, but the last Sunday in here, I'm saying. Going home, watching with our parents, watching on the couch with some homemade eggs. Or I guess for me, I'm switching over to the 10 o'clock, 1 o'clock slate.
That's dust.
Interesting.
That's dust.
Things are going to change for Gus. Also, FanDuel is not legal in California. Another wrinkle in the plan. I'm going to have to weasel some stuff. Regardless, we'll see you next Wednesday. Don't forget to ride the Gus Bus if you want to make some cheese. Peace.